Welcome to the Spy Collection Digital Edition, where we are looking at spy artifacts that only exist in digital format. This is Anastasios, and today we will look at the slide deck from the United States National Security Agency, an agency that, among others, has one of the largest signals intelligence, or SIGINT, organizations in the world. The slides we're going to see came from Edward Snowden's archive. Specifically, they were publicly released for the first time in March 2018 by The Intercept in this article. One of the most stereotypical visualizations of SIGINT organizations is photographs of large dishes or domes which hide similar antennas. Those domes typically have a dual purpose. One is to protect the antennas and the other is to conceal their technology and orientation. This is a classic SIGINT capability. They are basically used to receive whatever satellites of interest broadcast and then pass that data to processing centers. That could be a country's own spy satellite sending back data, or any foreign satellite, commercial or government operated, that they want to spy on. This is also why multiple antennas are needed and in multiple geographical regions, to be able to capture many transmissions from various satellites regardless of their orbit. When that slide deck was leaked, this was part of NSA's GAO, or Global Access Operations Division, under the data acquisition of the Signals Intelligence Directorate. GAO had the Radio Frequency Office, and in there is where we find the Foreign Satellites, or FORNSAT. And this is where we start. As usual, we have reconstructed the slide deck, and here is this version of the NSA's Managing the Challenge. So the revelations of that slide deck started quite early with this. What you see here is a small collection of commercial companies that offer satellite communication services. Actually, you might have heard of some of them, like Iridium phones or Inmarsat, Intelsat, etc. All of them offer subscription services for anyone to buy phones or radios that operate via their satellite networks. Typical users of those are maritime sector, search and rescue teams working in disasters, or remote locations, hikers, and others operating in remote locations. Of course, it's not unheard of that criminals, military personnel, as well as intelligence agencies use them too in case all other means fail. Especially considering that this slide deck is from 2013 or so, it is reasonable to see why the NSA would be interested in spying on those communications. That makes them the SATCOM targets. But how was this done? Using the Foreign Satellite Communication Exploitation Model. This model involved a few different stages. The first was the FSS, or Fixed Satellite Services. As the title implies, those were things like antennas, known satellite communication networks like Intelsat and the former Soviet Union satellites, other private satellite networks, as well as a project that the Five Eyes were running between 2007 and at least until 2013, the SV. SV, or SHAREDVISION, was a Five Eyes project to expand their satellite collection by adding more antennas and utilizing more sites around the globe for better coverage on all satellite broadcasts of interest. As mentioned, some of those commercial providers also offered mobile satellite services. So that was the second target, the MSS, or Mobile Satellite Services. So assuming all of that infrastructure is in place and is collecting broadcasts of interest, then comes the SNS, the Search and Survey. The screenshots that you see under the Get It column were from a Five Eyes exploitation system codenamed as DQ, or DARKQUEST. This was part of the shared vision that we already talked about, and what it was doing was inspecting the received data and making automated analysis on the type of that data. For example, it could identify that this was a phone call, that was a VPN connection, this is a message, etc. In the SIGINT world, this kind of tooling is referred to as automated survey system. With this information at hand, the SNS model moves to the second stage, the Know It. Here the slide shows us that the collected satellite communications are processed in the EKB. This likely stands for Exploitation Knowledge Base, and it has dual purpose. One, it is to add the newly acquired information, and the second, to correlate it with any existing information. And finally, all that information was available to the Five Eyes SIGINT analysts via a tool known as GLOBALVIEW. You can see some screenshots of it here. And that was how FORNSAT exploitation was executed by the NSA and the rest of the Five Eyes in 2013. However, the presentation goes one step further, giving us some real-world success stories of it. Actionable SIGINT. In the world of spies, actionable intelligence means an intelligence product, like a report, that the recipients can use it to take an action against the target. For example, details that can lead to the capture or assassination of an individual. What exactly a foreign politician has in his agenda for an upcoming meeting? Where will a person of interest be and when? Etc. And the first example was Mullah Dadullah Lang, who was a Taliban military commander and in 2007 was killed in Afghanistan. As we read in this official NATO press release, as reported earlier today by the government of Afghanistan, Mullah Dadullah Lang left his sanctuary into southern Afghanistan, where he was killed in a US-led coalition operation supported by ISAF. Well, now we know that what led to his assassination was a foreign satellite exploitation, meaning he or some of his associates used the satellite phone to communicate, and that was picked up by the NSA, who made an intelligence package and passed it to the coalition forces. The next case study was Harun Fazul, an Al-Qaeda leader from East Africa operating mainly in Kenya, who later became the Al-Shabaab commander in Somalia too. He was killed in Mogadishu, Somalia in June 7, 2011, while driving with another terrorist a car with large amounts of cash in US dollars, electronic devices and fake passports. They were stopped in a Somalia military checkpoint in Sarkusta and tried to escape. The soldiers killed both of them. Based on this and the leaked NSA slide, we can now assume that the NSA had detected Harun Fazul's movements via foreign satellite exploitation, passed the intelligence to the relevant US forces in Somalia, and worked with the Somali military to stop that car in that checkpoint. Next, Abdelmalek Druktel was an Algerian leader of Al-Qaeda in Morocco and later became the leader of the Al-Qaeda in Islamic Maghreb, or AQIM. He was also arrested, and actually in 2020 he was killed in a French special operations mission in Mali, Africa. And here we have Nader Shah, who was arrested. The JFK terrorist from 2007. That was a plot to blow up a system of jet fuel supply tanks and pipelines that feed fuel to the JFK International Airport in New York. The plot involved five people, and in the photo shown here is Karim Ibrahim, who was sentenced to life in prison. Suicide bombers were arrested via foreign satellite exploitation, and at last, the UK airport terrorist, which almost certainly refers to the two individuals behind the Glasgow airport attack in June 2007, that were also arrested. In this case, a jeep loaded with propane canisters was driven at the glass doors of the Glasgow airport terminal and set ablaze. And what did the NSA exploit for most of those cases? Was the commercially available Inmarsat constellation of satellites. This is known even to this day as I4, and it provides internet and telephony connections anywhere on Earth except the polar regions. Back when this slider was written, the official I4 satellite's description was geosynchronous constellation providing mobile communications at sea, on land and in the air. BGAN stands for Broadband Global Area Network and is a global satellite network with telephony owned by Inmarsat using portable terminals. Fleet Broadband is a maritime satellite internet telephony SMS and ISDN network for ocean-going vessels using portable domed terminal antennas. Swift Broadband is an internet communications network that provides an always-on data connection for aircraft globally. And iSatPhone is Inmarsat's handheld satellite phone. So those were the products that the company was offering at that point. Actually, most of them exist to this day too. But how did the NSA take advantage of this company's satellite services? via a program codenamed SEADIVER. As we are reading, SEADIVER is a system that collects, processes and forwards voice, fax and data traffic transmitted over the Inmarsat III satellite systems from foreign satellites and SCS trust collection facilities. SCS stands for Special Collection Service, and it was a covert joint operation between the NSA and CIA to utilize US embassies around the world to collect signals intelligence. Basically, CIA has presence in most, if not all, US embassies, so the NSA made a secret agreement with CIA to install SIGINT equipment in those embassies to collect communications. In a similar manner, Trust was a codename for British GCHQ spies operating clandestinely in UK's foreign embassies. Just like the SCS chase, Trust was a joint covert operation to install covert SIGINT equipment to collect communications in those embassies. So the NSA could use theirs and their allies' SIGINT stations as well as embassies to install the spying equipment to receive satellite communications, and it was called SEADIVER. Next was a program codenamed ZODIACARRAY, which is described as the system that targets Broadband Global Area Network, BGAN, a digital service providing rates of up to 492 kbps. It is IP-based activity to include voice. It is transmitted over the Inmarsat 4 satellite systems. So ZODIACARRAY was used to spy on the BGAN product of Inmarsat, and the last one was CANYONDUST. It says, it is a ground-based Inmarsat mobile terminal geolocation system that computes geolocations on all Inmarsat M, Mini-M, M4, B and C terminals within its coverage region. The geolocations are performed on the registration, access request, response burst or SCPC. The coverage region is defined as an area that is serviced by at least two Inmarsat satellites. This is a very interesting capability, since the NSA was able to use CANYONDUST to identify the exact location of the terminal that was used to communicate with the Inmarsat satellites. We can assume that while doing the operations mentioned, like access request, response burst, or single channel per carrier satellite links, the data included the coordinates of the terminal or something similar for the mentioned models, thus allowing the NSA to know exactly where they are physically located during the communication. And that was this small slide deck on how the NSA was exploiting commercial satellite communications products for signals intelligence. We went through the foreign satellite communication exploitation model, the search and survey methodology, and even briefly described several previously unknown SIGINT programs like the SHAREDVISION of the Five Eyes, DARKQUEST, GLOBALVIEW, CANYONDUST and others. We even saw how US and UK embassies were clandestinely utilized to install covert SIGINT equipment for satellite exploitation, and finally, how even a private company like Inmarsat in this case has to be putting security first, since minor issues could expose even the exact locations of their customers. The next time you come across a satellite product, an embassy with some concealed antennas, or even while browsing the internet in a cruise ship or an airplane, keep in mind that someone could be listening. Nothing is as it seems.